In this video, you'll see four approaches to using an object as dependency of a React useEffect. All have their pros and cons, from being simple yet ineffective to ugly yet efficient. Let me walk you through an example I encountered while working on a coding task. Now, this looks all fine, but actually using the params object as a dependency here is problematic. Remember how we passed the params object from the issueList component to this hook? During each render, this object is created from scratch. The useEffect internally compares the dependencies by reference, and since the reference to the params object is a different one for each render, the effect would be run with every render as well. This is less than ideal, but not that easy to spot. A simple solution is to spread all values of this object as dependencies. Technically, this isn't problematic, because the effect is run whenever one of the values of the params object changes. But we get a lint warning, and would have to disable it to commit our code. While disabling warnings isn't necessarily a huge problem, this could lead us to forget about a missing dependency later if we, for example, add another filter. This could then lead to a hard-to-find bug. Another approach is to destructure each filter and pass it as a separate dependency. But this is a bit tedious, and we might forget to add a new parameter if new filters are introduced. Another approach is using this useDeepCompare effect, created by CanSeeDots. This hook is similar to the native useEffect, but instead of comparing the dependencies by reference, it makes a deep comparison of all values inside an object. Let's give it a try. First, we install the dependency. Then, let's undo the previous changes. Then, we replace the useEffect with a new useDeepCompare effect hook. We can now simply pass the params object as dependency and the effect won't be run on every render anymore. The problem with this hook? When we remove a required dependency like the params object, we don't get a lint warning about missing dependencies. So this isn't really better than our array destructuring approach before. Final approach that I saw Dan Abramov recommend somewhere is stringifying the object and parsing it again inside the effect. This works well with small and not too deeply nested objects that don't contain function values. Honestly, it doesn't look that great, but combines all of the advantages. It decreases the risk of forgetting to add filters and the risk of forgetting to add a dependency in the future, all while keeping the ESLint check intact. Interestingly, the error in the getIssues function is gone here. When we check the type of nextPageParams, the reason becomes clear. It has the type any. The fix is simple. We just define the type of the innerParams.